Hello and welcome. I am Jessica Loper, here to offer you intuitive and practical guidance here every 2 weeks. I am going to slightly change the topic, so I'll still be on every 2 weeks. I was going to switch back and forth between in the flow and on and staying on track, but I've decided just to combine it. That way I can just share around whatever I feel led to, or maybe some weeks I'll do a little bit of both. So still sticking with the same overall themes of in the flow and staying on track. And the reason for that, in case you're new here, is I just feel like they are two very important aspects, opposite sides of the spectrum, to just really being able to show up as your true self and meet your goals. So we'll just kind of tap into both areas as we go through this every 2 weeks, and hopefully it supports you in whatever goals or intentions you have been setting or are about to set, and doing it in a way that is true to you and aligned for your path, your purpose. So today, what is on my mind is getting back on track when you've kind of like slipped up, or maybe not really shown up in the way that you really wanted to. And what led me to this topic is that I myself last week had set some goals for myself and didn't quite meet it. And it's interesting. The old me, you know, several months ago probably would have just kind of like given up and been too hard on myself and just kind of stopped trying. It's kind of the pattern I would have. I was very much all or nothing when it came to my goals, and I didn't really allow myself enough space for just, you know, life happening, or the fact that we're human and we're not perfect, right? We're perfectly imperfect. So I just want to encourage you, if there's something where maybe you just didn't quite do as well as you had hoped, or maybe you set a goal to do something every day and you missed a day, just give yourself that grace and get going. Like, can you just start again today? Or tomorrow, depending on what time you're watching this, okay? So if you've been watching the last few videos, then I would invite you to just reflect on any goals or intentions you have set throughout the past time here, right? And if it helps, have a notebook, have a journal. That's something that definitely helps me too. I actually prefer to use a spreadsheet more than anything. Even it is kind of like my journal in a way, I guess you could say, a lot. So I have my spreadsheet, and if I have like daily tasks or weekly goals, whatever it is, I like to list them out, check them off. And then I also have a little notebook that I use for various things too. I'm a person that likes to track things, so that's just what helps me hold myself accountable. And it kind of forces me to look at it every day. Right? Like, if you don't write it down, or even, I mean, use your phone, use the notes section in your phone, or send yourself an email, whatever it is. You do have to remember to look at it though. In which case, if you're not looking at the paper or the spreadsheet or whatever it is, then maybe set a reminder of some kind, or alarm, or put it on a calendar. Because checking in with yourself is definitely going to help most people stay accountable. With that being said, I know everyone kind of does things their own way. Definitely encourage you to find your way of tracking things for yourself. So play around, try some different things, and I just want to offer that reminder that we're gonna slip up sometimes, you know. It's even like with grades, it makes me think of that too, like being in school as a kid, teenager, college, whatever you're doing. Maybe you're in school now. Like, I feel like I'm constantly giving my son that reminder because he's been hard on himself on his grades lately, is did you do your best? You know, and kind of giving him that space that like you don't have to be perfect, but did you do your best? Did you show up? And if you didn't, did you acknowledge that mistake and are you going to do better this week? You know? So for me, last week I set a goal to work out 6 out of 7 days, which is less than I was doing before I finished the 75 hard program a little over 2 weeks ago. And I've been meaning to make a video specific to that. I haven't done that yet. I'll have to do that and upload it here in the next few days, hopefully, just to share more of that journey because it really did help me with consistency. But I've noticed that since completing that, it has actually been easier for me to be consistent, but also just get right back on track if something slips up. So yeah, I had set the goal last week to work out 6 out of 7 days, and I only did five, right? And so the way I used to be, like, and this is just like several months ago, right? I used to be the type where if I missed a day or didn't hit my goal perfectly, I'd kind of like just give up and do nothing at all. Like, I would have just like not worked out for a few weeks or a few days or whatever just because I didn't do it perfect, right? So, very much have kind of an all or nothing. And same with like diet and nutrition, same thing. So I am happy to say that I'm doing much better at not being so hard on myself. And today I got up and I went on my run. Even though I didn't do my workout goal perfectly last week, I'm starting over this week with the same goal, and I'm not going to give up just because I didn't do it the way I wanted to last week. So I think that's my overall reminder for today is just get back up and start again. Whatever it is, if there's something you missed. All right, that's all I have for today. So, thank you for watching. Please like this video, share it with a friend if you have someone you think would benefit from this. And I will be back in a couple weeks. Take care.